Hey guys, so today I'm going to be showing you how to erase a face in Photoshop CS5. And what I mean by erase a face is if you want to, say, get rid of some features, mouth or eyebrows or something, basically I'm going to show you how to do that so that it looks like there's skin on top and you can then put anything you want, whether it's, I don't know, say you want someone else's lips there or you want anything you could possibly imagine. So basically, I'm going to open Photoshop and then go to your internet and download, I don't know, any picture. So say, let's get a celebrity, Leonardo DiCaprio. Get one that's not so heavily edited already. As you can see, this one, you can see clearly that things have been done to it. It's not how the original picture actually looked. Whereas this one's more natural, but of course it's small. So look for a good size. This is 900 by 902. You want to look for a relatively large one. This one would be really good. So yeah, I guess we could work with that one. Let's do this. So what you want to do is right click, save image as. You can name it anything, Leo face. I'm going to just save it to my desktop. There you go, it's downloaded. And then what you're going to do is open up Photoshop. From my home screen, I just take drag and drop. Now that you have this, you just click enter on the keyboard. Okay, because as you can see, there's this little crosshair on the picture. That means that you can move it around and that it can be adjusted. So I click enter and done. Now, before you can edit it, currently this is a smart object. What you want to do is right click on the picture, click rasterize layer right here, rasterize layer. Once you do this, you can pretty much do anything to the picture you want. This is just how you imagine Photoshop, where you can edit whatever you'd like. So see, I took that off. Of course, it just did take his collar off. You can edit that however you want. If you do want to get the finer spots, you could just right click on the magic wand and do a quick selection tool so you can kind of select whatever you want. But we don't need that right now because I'm not going to be putting anything in the background. So let's maximize this a little. Let's zoom in. To zoom in with proportionality, you'll have to do left click along with shift so that it moves equally. So we have this, click enter after I've moved. Always remember to click enter, otherwise it won't let you do anything. And now, basically just go to your healing tool, which is right over here. There's four options: spot healing, healing, patch, and red eye. Some people like to do patch, which is basically they outline this area and now they can move it around. So if you want someone's eye up there, you can do that. We don't want that. So Control Z to undo that. What I want to do is I'm going to go to healing brush tool and you hold alternate on Windows or option on Mac. Hold alt and just left click on a patch of skin. And after that, don't drag, start clicking. And as you can see, there go his wrinkles right there. Okay, so look at this. We've made him a solid, I don't know, 5-10 years younger from just doing that. If you could get rid of this. There you go, it looks like a little baby now. So basically, if you want to get rid of the features, you just grab a patch of skin that looks like, that matches the rest of his face, and then you can start doing that. So let's go closer to his face over here. So I'd start doing this and start patching it up. It looks like he has a little stubble. What you want to do if you want to zoom in and get closer is hold alternate or option on Mac. Hold it and use your scroll wheel and start just scrolling in. And as you can see, wherever the pointer is, it'll scroll in right there. So put the pointer where you want it. You can go up and down. And then if you want to go side to side without having to go to the bottom bar, hold control and do the scroll wheel. Scroll wheel down will pull to the right. Scroll up is to the left. So here we get a bit closer. See, and once you go off, you kind of get this blemish over here. You don't want to go off his skin. You want to stay on, stay accurate, And that basically you could just erase. You can also increase the size of this. So there you go, see? But then this happens. You start uncovering another Leo. You don't want to do that. So, oops. Okay, so basically keep it small. Keep it a sizable outline. And from there, then you can just keep, you know, grab another patch of skin. Start doing that. Maybe grab something a bit rosy. And then you get on with this, and it takes a little while, but the outcome I'll show you in just a second. Okay, so here we have it. This is Leonardo DiCaprio. We've taken off his facial hair, and as you can see, you're gonna be like, well, you know, that doesn't look all that great, actually. And it doesn't. That's why if you put something else on it, so say I want to get another picture, and I say funny mouth. Okay, let's just go with this one for now. So save image as, save it to your desktop, name it ugly mouth. Okay, so it's saved there. Close that. Again, make it a smaller window because it's easier to drag in. Drag and drop anywhere you want. And there you have it. Now, you resize the picture. And I'm not going to be, you know, showing you any layers or anything. But I mean, what are they called? Masks or anything. Because we don't really need that for this. For such a simple thing to do on Facebook. Now, grab your lasso. And what you want to do is accurately go around the mouth. As accurately as possible, getting just the lips. And it's okay if you go off a little, you could always just edit it later. There's the erase tool, which is really nice to use for if you kind of mess up on this. Now you have this. What you want to do is hold Control or Command and click J. That basically makes a layer, a new layer, of what you just outlined. So if I hide this, see, there you go, there's just the mouth. Now you go to resize, bring it down to whatever you want, right? So what I should have done actually is, I should have erased his mouth, and I'm gonna do that. I'll be right back. And we're back. Okay, so what basically right now, Leo looks like Deadpool, if you've seen X-Men Origins. And that's exactly what we want, actually. So now we go to the mouth layer, which is right here. I can delete this one. You don't need this one anymore. So delete that. Yes. Go to the mouth. Bring the mouth over here. Zoom in, Alt and scroll wheel. Size it to however you want it. Okay, so just place it there for now, and you're going to be like, wow, well, that looks disgusting. And I'll agree with you, it does. What you do now is grab the eraser, make sure it's on one of these, okay? Not the solid ones, you want the one that fades out on the outside, okay? Basically, that lets you get close to your object without actually erasing everything completely. So as you can see, I'll show you zooming in a bit. See, look, right there. It takes away the extra edges and stuff. And this isn't a really quick process. You know, you have to take your time. But as you keep doing it, you do get a lot better with practice. I've only done this a few times, and my speed has increased already. And see, there you go. There's a mouth. It doesn't look all that great. And to kind of match... kind of match the skin tone and stuff that he has, you go to this tool over here. It's the Dodge, Burn, and Sponge tool. Dodge basically makes everything brighter, as I'll show you right here. Okay, so you go like that. That's dodge. Okay, you just keep making everything brighter and lighter. Burn, you could probably guess, does the opposite. Actually, I don't remember what sponge does. Oh yeah, sponge makes everything gray. It sucks the color out of it. Burn makes everything darker. It gives it a more orange or brown color to it. So if you want to like do a fake spray tan or something, you burn the whole person. Of course, as you keep going, it keeps getting darker and it chars, just like an actual burn. So we don't want that. We want to go to the mouth and we want to just zoom in and, you know, just slowly start burning to make it less of this pink color, you know. Well, that's a bit too black. Let's say he's a smoker. I think he is a smoker. Anyways, so there you have it. You have now erased his mouth by using the healing tool right over here. And then you match the skin by holding Alt and then clicking on a patch of skin that you want. Don't drag it. It'll start replicating the whole area that you've kind of taken it from. And just tap. It'll take a little while, but you can do it. Don't make the cursor too big. You don't want that, because it just doesn't look that great. Wow, he looks amazing. I just want to say. And so there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed. This has been a tutorial on how to actually erase but not remove the skin of a person's features. So I hope it helps you out, and please come back for more. Thanks for watching.